What's up, guys? Joe Edmonds here once again, and the red Komodo. Just about 3-4 months ago, I switched from the red Epic Dragon. I got rid of it and then picked up the Canon C200, which I didn't like at all. Then I switched to the Canon 1DX Mark III. The reason that I switched to the 1DX Mark III as final is because over the years of using and owning red equipment, or red cameras to be precise, I've realized that the weight is taking a toll on me, especially when I'm filming music videos, doing handheld or gimbal or light cam. After a few hours, and then by the time you get home, your back starts to hurt, your biceps are all curling up, starting to hurt, and so the weight of the red cameras has been a big issue for me. Nevertheless, I do love the color signs of red compared to any other camera. But one thing that I would like to highlight is people tend to get a misconception about red versus any other cameras, or ARRI versus any other cameras. It's technically just like an iPhone and Samsung. So iPhone, obviously, over the years, it gives you the exact same thing. There was no change in the physical aspect, no change in the software, but people are loyal to it because it's made its name, it's made its mark in the industry, and people trust and rely on that iPhone. And the same goes for red versus any other cameras. With red, it has been more or less the first camera in the industry that actually filmed 4K, which was the MX sensor, and then later 5K. And prior to that, there weren't any other camera, nor ARRI or Canon or any other camera out there that was shooting 4K. So when red came out with 4K, it shook up the industry, and so with that resolution, it made its mark as red. And then also, with besides the resolution, the fact that it was able to shoot RAW. We know that RAW is a must, especially being a filmmaker or a music video producer or run and gun personnel. I mean, someone that shoots a lot against harsh conditions, RAW is a must. And so when Red came out with the MX 4K RAW, again, people were crazy about it because you could manipulate the image so much. And this is half a decade ago. So if fast forward to now, there are so many cameras out there that have given us 4K and even higher. I'm not saying Red is not doing that anymore. Red currently's highest end cinema camera is the Helium 8K. And so other companies out there are also giving us 8K, if not 6K, 5K, 4K, and RAW. And so the competition has now been somewhat very, very blurred. And the reason why people are sticking to red is because of the color science and the flexibility and the dynamic range that you get with a red camera compared to others. And so I do love the capabilities of red cameras, but just the weight was the big issue. So that's the reason why I switched to the Canon 1DX Mark III right now, because because obviously the 1DX Mark III is giving me 5.5K raw, and yes, the dynamic range is not as high as the red camera. I believe it's 13-stop dynamic range, 12-13-stop dynamic range. Nothing crazy, but I'm not too fussed about the dynamic range because as a cinematographer, we always like our scenes, unless, again, you're run and gun personnel that needs that high dynamic range, because you're not going to be able to light the scene. And so I switched to the 1DX for that reason. But now Red has announced the Komodo 6K, and that is making me think twice whether I should stick with the 1DX Mark III or whether I should switch back to Red ecosystem. What would you do if you were in that predicament? Would you stick with a camera that you just purchased less than 2 months ago, or would you switch back to the Red? For me, I feel that the Red is a best fit for my needs, and also because I have used it for so many years and I know their workflow very well, and I know the image very well in terms of manipulation compared to the Canon. So it seems only logical for me to switch back to the Komodo 6K. Now, there is one main reason that I'm still hanging by a thread, is the image quality, the sensor quality. Is it going to be the same as the MX sensors? Is it going to be the same as the Dragon sensor? Or is it going to be the DSM-T2 Dragon sensor? I am not a big fan of the DSM-T2 sensor quality. Yes, it has a very top-notch image quality, it's very sharp and whatnot, but the MX sensor was very, very organic. It looked very, very filmic compared to the DSM-T2 newer sensor image. I mean, I'm pretty sure you agree with that. There are so many people out there that currently are still sticking with their Red MX sensor, the Scarlet, the Epic, the Epic X, the Epic Dragon, the Scarlet Dragon, the Dragon. Those are the sensors that actually broke through and touched our hearts, if I should say. And now that the DSM-T2 has come out, with my comparison and having used the Raven and the Scarlet W before, I noticed personally that the DSM-T2 image is a little bit more digital than the previous MX sensor. If you agree, leave a comment below. If you disagree, let me know what your thoughts are. But that is my personal opinion. And so that is what I'm concerned about, that will it be the current up-to-date sensor, or will it contain that organic look sensor from the Red Epic and the Red Scarlet? And so this is what I'm going to leave it by. Let's see what time will tell. Currently, a month's time supposedly is when the Komodo will be released. There is a few images here and there on YouTube, but nothing really in depth in terms of quality-wise. And obviously, having said that, with YouTube compression as well, you're never going to be able to actually physically feel or see the difference between that particular sensor and the previous sensor. So I'll leave it here, and if you have any thoughts, go ahead and leave it in the comment below. Do hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed before, and if you are a subscriber, don't forget to hit the notification bell, and I'll catch you on the next one. Stay tuned, and I'll see you soon. Peace.